Hello and welcome to the Betting Picks video for the Sunday slate of NFL Week 3. I'm your host for Lineups.com, Matthew Amato. We got Patrick Monin, Jason Gilbo, and Jacob Wayne. We got the Packers at the Bucs. This game is just... what the heck is happening? I'll go first on this one. Under 42 points. I think both of these offenses are not going to be able to do anything on the opposing defense. I think Leonard Fournette, Aaron Jones, and A.J. Dillon are the only source of offense for this one. I mean, Brady has no weapons left. Aaron Rodgers never had weapons to begin with. I really, really like the Bucs defense. I still think it's the best defense in the league. I think the Packers are pretty solid there, especially when Tom Brady has no one to throw to. This is going to be like the Saints-Bucs game all over again. 42 is way too high, which is crazy because it's only 42 points and it's Aaron Rodgers and Tom Brady, but it's kind of where we are right now. That's my feelings on the game. I'm not going either way. I'm just going to take that under and enjoy that. Jacob?
Yeah, so I bet the Packers yesterday at 2.5, and then, they were already dealing with their injuries, like you mentioned. The Bucs were. And then today, the Packers had Randall Cobb, Christian Watson, Alan Lazard, and Sammy Watkins hit the injury report, which is fantastic. I don't know. I like the Packers in this game just because I think they're going to be able to limit, like, the Bucs will be much more of a one-dimensional offense regardless of who's active in this game. Just because Mike Evans is out, Julio Jones is likely out, Chris Godwin's not going to be at 100% even if he plays. So I would lean the Packers, and also, like, the Bucs offense, even when they've had some of these guys, they haven't really moved the ball at all in these games. They really struggled in the red zone Week 1, and then last week they really benefited from those Jameis Winston interceptions late in the game to inflate their final score. So I do like the under, and I don't think these quarterbacks are necessarily, like, turnover prone. Like, sometimes you can see in a low-scoring game the total go over because of interceptions, like putting the other team in the red zone or running back for a touchdown. Like, I don't think you're going to see a ton of turnovers, just stalled drives and 3 and outs. So I do like the under, and I would lean Packers for right now.
If I can get over on punting yardage, I would love those bets. Jason?
Yep, this was the one I was eyeing kind of in the week that I thought the Packers would be in kind of a decent spot. And obviously I think that number got helped out a little bit with obviously the Evans suspension, but also just Vita Vea being out is a big deal for that Bucs defensive line. Tampa Bay's run defense, 15th in DVOA to start the year, I don't think it's quite as good as it has been in prior years. I don't think it's actually going to even get back to that point. I mean, Dallas was able to really exploit it in that Week 1 game, and I think Aaron Jones, A.J. Dillon will be able to do a little bit of that here. I think with the Packers defense, I'm going to ride this one. I think they're in a good spot to kind of do the job. Like, I would really sell out against the run on the Packers and force really Brady to throw to what now is really, really pedestrian wide receivers. So, under, this game stays close. I think Packers go on the road and steal this one.
And Patrick.
Yeah, I mean, I'm a Tom Brady hater, but I do love the Bucs here. Primarily because I think this defense is the best defense in the NFL right now, both pass rush and in run pursuit. Understandably, Cowboys and Saints, they aren't world beaters on offense, but this Bucs team made them look juvenile at times. I think this coaching duo of Bowles and Leftwich has a better grip on this team. And I just don't think the Packers are going to be able to run the ball like they have for 2 weeks. And that's been their bread and butter on offense. I think Rodgers is going to be under pressure in this game. In this Bucs offense, we saw last year, they've consistently been a completely different team at home. They're going at home here, getting him a less than 3. I do like the Bucs. I don't love either team. I think they're both a little overvalued, but I think the Packers are a little bit more overvalued than the Bucs are.
So, Jason, you're saying Vita Vea is confirmed out, right?
Do you mean Akeem Hicks?
Oh, yeah, sorry. I think yes, Hicks, not Vita Vea. Yeah, sorry. Yeah.
Okay, I was going to say, because I saw Akeem Hicks, and I was like, you mean Akeem Hicks and
Vita Vea? No, Hicks, sorry.
Out?
Yeah,
I was going to say, if they're both out. Like.
And it's like, Patrick, it is interesting because they're 15 DVOA, though I do agree. But if with Akeem Hicks out, I'm a little bit more nervous. Like that, I mean, who am I to say? I'm not actually taking a pick. I'm the one pansying out on this one and not choosing a team. I'm just going with the under. So, but I kind of share your sentiment, Patrick. I am a little worried about this specific game with the injuries.
I'd probably just wait. I would wait until Sunday to make a bet on this game if you're going to bet it, because I don't think it's going to change that much. Like, I don't think either team is going to end up being favored by more than 3 points, and it won't matter that much what line you get. And I would just wait until we have more information on who's actually available for these teams.
Do we like the Aaron Jones rushing yards at 52.5? A.J. Dillon, 49.5? Leonard Fournette, 71.5? Any of those? No? All right, let's get out of here. I got under 42. I think we're all on the under. Jacob, Jason on the Packers at +1, -110. Patrick, Buccaneers, -1 at -110. Let's move on. That is going to wrap it up for us in this Sunday slate video. Thank you so much for watching. As always, you can click the like button if you liked this video. If you didn't like this video, go ahead and give it a dislike. Comment down below your favorite bets. Hit the subscribe button if you're interested in seeing more content like this. Click the bell if you want to get notified when our videos go up. Like Jacob said, we have tons of betting analysis on lineups.com. You can find matchup previews, player prop articles, and parlay strategies for literally every single NFL game on lineups. You can also find the best promo codes for sportsbooks. You can find sportsbook reviews. You can find legal guides to your state and what is legally allowed to be bet on in your state. So we got you covered on lineups.com. Thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you next time very soon.